we continue to bring you people's issues on Face the People. On this program, we try to empower people instead of just debating the state. Tonight, we appeal for justice for Sunita Naik. A former magazine editor, Sunita Naik today lives on the streets of Mumbai. She was once affluent. Today, she is a penniless footpath dweller. We're sending out an appeal on our show tonight. If you are watching and if you would like to, please do help Sunita Naik. First, a report from Kajal Iyer.
She may look like a beggar today. Sunita Naik once owned two flats in Mumbai's posh Worli and rode in chauffeur-driven cars. Well-educated and able to speak in five languages, she was the editor of Grihalakshmi, a famous Mumbai weekly. After she retired in 2007, Naik sold her flats in Worli and settled in Thane. That's when her descent to poverty began.
I was having very good life. My food used to come in from Taj Mahal Hotel both the time, and I used to have food from Taj Mahal Hotel. From 91, my period is come worse. And I'm sick. What to do? I can't help.
Sunita's finances were handled by a former associate whose number she no longer has. She's mystified as to how her bank balance became zero and says only her associate could answer this question. What was left was drained by her failing health. Sunita eventually gave up her residence at Thane, hoping to take up a rented house in Versova to continue her treatment for kidney stones. But with astronomical rents, Sunita found that all she could afford was the footpath. She has now taken shelter in a gurdwara.
ये तो 6 महीने से यहाँ पर है, जरूरतमंद है इसलिए बैठी हुई है। मैंने इसको कितनी दफा बोला है कि मैं तुम्हें चल के लेडीज विंग में ले चलता हूँ, तेरी मैं पूरी हेल्प कराता हूँ, मैं पुलिस के जरिए तेरी हेल्प कराता हूँ, लेडीज वो जाने को तैयार नहीं है।
Sunita Naik says she still has the ability to earn a living. All she needs is a little help. With Dinesh Maurya and Kajal Iyer in Mumbai, in New Delhi, Shailaja Varma.
Just to emphasize that Face the People is your show, it's a people's show, so tweet us with hashtag Sunita Naik and do respond in to us if you have any comments or any questions on this issue of the elderly homeless. And joining us tonight, Sunita Naik, she is the homeless ex-millionaire and former editor of Grihalakshmi magazine. She is right now with George Miskita, who has adopted her. Remember, we've been playing the story of Sunita Naik all of today, and as a result of our story and as a result of the media campaign, because a number of other media channels have also taken up her case, George Miskita has adopted her, he is telling us. We also have Indu Prakash Singh. You are head City Makers Program, Indo Global Social Service Society, looking after the elderly and the homeless. Matthew Cherian, who doesn't know him, CEO of HelpAge India. And G.S. Bhatia, you are living in an old age home, Gharonda, and you were disowned by your own children. Aapke apne bacche ne aapko ghar se bahar kar diya tha. We're talking about the elderly homeless with Sunita Naik, who is a former millionaire with lots of property earlier, but now was on the footpath penniless. We're asking, is there no help available for those who fall on bad times? Let's start by asking Sunita. Sunita, how did you fall on such bad times? How did you end up on the footpath outside that gurdwara?
Yeah, I don't know what happened to me, but you know, it is really, time is very bad and very worse.
Right. And Sunita, you are an educated person. You are highly educated. You are former editor of Grihalakshmi magazine. Did you not try to find a job, any employment?
No, because you know, I can't find a job on the footpath. I must have some shelter, you know.
So have you been adopted now by Mr. George Miskita?
Yeah, yeah. They are very nice couple and I am very happy with them.
So you are no longer living on the footpath?
No.
Sunita, would you like to tell us?
They have a good house and they are treating me nice.
And are there any family members? Do you have any family members who... Do you have any family members who you can contact?
No, I don't have any family member.
And what kind of troubles did you have when you were on the footpath? How did you manage in the Mumbai monsoon, a lady alone living on the footpath? What kind of trouble did you have?
There was a too much trouble in monsoon. I had too much trouble in monsoon, but you know what to do. I am a brave person. I had to face it for all difficulties.
And you had two flats, you had a bungalow, you had a house in Pune. How did you lose all this?
I lost, you know, there are some, you know, I used to pay very high rents and my half of the money gone in the rent, and I don't know how my bank balance is finished so quick.
And do you feel that somebody robbed you? Did somebody do dirty tricks with you? Did somebody take away your money?
Yeah, I'm having, I feel my staff, you know, who is my employee, I'm having doubt on them.
And what happened to the magazine that you were editor of, Grihalakshmi magazine? They didn't try to help you?
It was out of, afterwards I was out of touch with everybody.
So how long were you living on the footpath there, outside that Gurdwara?
Then now I'm not living, now I'm with the family, now I don't live, but I was living last 2 months, you know.
Right, and you didn't have any friends who were helping you, any old friends, any associates, you were completely alone?
Yeah, I'm completely alone. Some friends have helped me, definitely, but I don't like to ask myself, you know.
So you are completely alone. Sunita Nayak's tragedy, Indu Prakash Singh, if I can put it to you, she was an editor of Grihalakshmi magazine. She owned two flats. She had a house in Pune, and she's reduced at the age of 65 to living on a footpath outside a Gurdwara. The Gurdwara is the only place which has given her shelter and which gave her food. Is this a story that can happen, is happening across the country? Is it happening to many more people?
Well, we have been working with the homeless for the last 13 years, and I must tell you that on the streets of Delhi and many other cities where our work is going on, these are similar stories, you know. I remember I met one woman at Old Delhi station a few years back, and we asked as to how did she land up at the station. She said that, well, her husband had passed away, and her children had thrown her out, and she landed up at the station, and two or three women would sleep huddled together at the station because that provides them safety. And similar stories are there where we have got a journalist staying in a shelter in Chabi Ganj, and he used to write, he's still there, Mr. Kamal Bhushan, from Ludhiana. So there are umpteen number of stories, you know, of old people being left by the family.
Families abandon them.
Oh, yes.
They don't have any money to fall back on. They don't have any property.
Nothing.
So they're literally out on the street.
Literally, in fact, we have come across, like only last week we have a night vision program. Just close to Red Fort, we found an old man sleeping on the road, not the street. And there were PCR vans which passed by. We were going, we stopped the van that we have, and we spoke to him. He was speaking Punjabi. You know what happens at the when you grow old, you also have a lot of amnesia and all, you start forgetting things. He couldn't narrate things, and thankfully we have got a friend in this Guru Vishram Vridashram in Badarpur. We took him there, and he's been taken care of. So there are so many people we come across in Delhi and other cities, you know. It's not one story, but it's stories of hundreds of people.
Right. Yes. And in hundreds of people is absolutely right. Matthew Cherian, 1 million elderly are homeless in India. There are 70,000 elderly homeless in Delhi alone. Clearly, we need serious social security systems to deal with this problem, which are clearly lacking. What kind of social security systems do we need to deal with the scale of the problem? Because we have one Sunita Nayak here whose plight is so very shocking, but there are 70,000 elderly in Delhi alone.
Actually, we have a huge problem of homelessness across cities, both in tier tier 1 cities and tier 2 cities. And what is happening about elderly is they have no social security.
Mm-hmm.
So after they do not have an income, then they are, if the children don't look after them, then there is no social security. The state gives only for 200 rupees pension to those who have a BPL card.
Mm-hmm.
So we have been asking for a universal pension system so that everybody gets some form of pension. This is one of the major issues. The second major issue is about elderly is what is the address they give.
Mm-hmm.
Today we have a UID system.
Mm-hmm.
What is the address the homeless give? Will they give lamppost number 23? Will they give outside Gurudwara gate number 2? Or like the widows in Vrindavan, they are outside various ashrams and temples. What is the identity they give? So they don't have a ration card, they don't have a BPL card, they don't have an identity. In spite, and because of all this, they do not get a pension.
Mm-hmm.
So these are people who do not have an identity, who are stateless, because they don't belong to the Indian state.
It really makes the case, doesn't it, for younger people to save for their old age, to make provision for their old age, to ensure they get that pension. Because as you say, you are now campaigning for that universal pension. But it is ultimately how much funds you have at your disposal that guarantees your dignity in old age. It is your financial self-sufficiency that guarantees your dignity. I'll come back to the pension question in just a bit. Let me put to Mr. G.S. Bhatia. You're living in an old age home. Bhatia, sir, आप घरौंदा में रहते हैं
जी,
आपके जो बच्चे हैं
वो ही
आपको घर से निकाल दिया?
हाँ, उन्होंने बेस्ट करके हम मुझे बाहर निकाल दिया। और दो बच्चे मेरे हैं, राकेश जैन, प्रवेश जैन, जिन्होंने मुझे सहारा देकर स्टैंड किया है। इसी पे मैं, जो हमारे बच्चों ने हमारे से बदतमीजी की, उसके ऊपर एक शेर अर्ज करता हूँ। वो ये है, पल दो पल कुछ पल दो पल मिलती हैं खुशियां, कुछ पल दो पल मिलते हैं गम। जो गमों में साथ ना छोड़े, राकेश जैन, प्रवेश जैन जैसे बेटे मिलते हैं कम।
वाह, क्या आप समझते हैं भाटिया जी कि अगर आपके पास संपत्ति होती, अगर आपके पास कोई प्रॉपर्टी होता, तो फिर आप इस स्थिति में नहीं होते कि आपके बच्चे आपके साथ ही होते? अगर आपके पास अपना घर होता, मकान होता, पेंशन होता?
हाँ, हो सकता था ऐसा हो, लेकिन मुझे उम्मीद नहीं है कि जो बच्चे इस तरीके से, माँ बाप ने उनको खुद भूखे रहकर उनको खिलाया, खुद नंगे रहकर उनको पनाया, इसलिए नहीं पनाया गया कि वो बुढ़ापे में आकर उनको धक्के देके बाहर निकाले, बल्कि उनकी लाठी का सहारा बने, लेकिन वो सहारा नहीं बन पाए।
It's the children themselves that are pushing the parents out onto the streets. Let's get you some Twitter feedback now. We have MM Umashankar writing, "What happened to Nayak's wealth? Editor did not know how to take it up with appropriate authorities." CP Chindia is writing in, "The identity of people around you becomes crystal clear when you fall on bad times. So trust yourself before others." J.S. Narula, 1974, is writing in, "There should be institutions like Langar where homeless elderly can have meal and shelter with dignity." That's a very good point. Perhaps it's the religious institutions that in the end come forward and provide this kind of dignity when the government fails. Sunita Nayak, I just want to ask you, did you have a good time at that Langar at the Gurdwara? Did the Gurdwara people look after you well?
Yeah, sometimes they used to give me food, sometimes they might not also.
Right.
I used to go out and eat.
And where did you get the money that you had, the little bit of money that you had, where did you get it from?
I was sitting at Gurudwara's visiting, so that time passing people, I never asked them, but they used to give me by wish, means,
so were
with
you,
their own wishes.
So were you begging? Were you begging for money?
No, not at all. Even somebody offers also, I never take from them.
And Sunita, what would you like now? Do you want to get a job? Do you want to try and unite with any family member? Would you like to reach out to any friend? What would you like to? See now, how do you see your future?
No, now I got a very good family member. They are a couple and they are looking after me very nicely. They have a very good house also.
And would you still like to get some employment?
Pardon?
Would you like to get some employment?
Pardon?
Since you are so educated, since you are such an educated person, would you like to get some employment?
Yeah, I want to do something because I am a brave person. I want to do something in my life. I don't want to depend on anybody.
I don't want to depend on anyone, says Sunita Naik. She is a former magazine editor. She's highly educated. She speaks 5 languages. She's been living on the footpath in front of a gurdwara for 2 months. And she says she wants to be self-sufficient and not depend on anyone. That really is the cry coming out from so many homeless elderly. They want their dignity and they want their self-sufficiency. And that is where the state is failing. Let's take a short break and come back and look for solutions. What can be done with this terrible tragedy in our society of the homeless elderly. We're sending out an appeal on this edition of Face the People. Please help Sunita Naik. She's a 65-year-old former magazine editor who's lost all her money and has been living on the footpath for 2 months. She has been adopted by a Good Samaritan, but she wants a job and she wants to be self-sufficient. Sunita Naik, from magazine editor to penniless dweller on the footpath. Indu, I just wanted to ask you, what kind of threats would a woman particularly like Sunita be facing living on the streets? And an elderly woman, but still living on the streets and vulnerable to all kinds of forces.
See, we have found women being victims of rape, sexual assault, in a big way, you know, and whether it be a woman, of a girl, mm-hmm. or a woman or elderly, nobody's spared. And, you know, like, that's the thing which I think many may not also want to share, mm-hmm. but one that we had in our own film, you know, we saw that
right.
She was sharing how she was being raped by the police and by the people, and not a single complaint was registered in any police station.
By people as well as by the police.
Yes.
So women on the street who are living on the street are seen as that kind of forces. Matthew, but what about shelters? Why is the government not investing in more shelters? Why aren't private agencies coming forward with more shelters? What about NGOs coming forward with more shelters? You heard Sunita say in the monsoon is when she had a particularly bad time. It's pretty shocking that a city like Bombay does not have at least shelters during that terrifying monsoon.
It is a situation which is playing out in every city. There are not enough shelters for the homeless, and the government is not trying. The NGOs, like what Indu represents, HelpAge runs a shelter in Delhi, in Bombay, but these are just too few. And there are no shelters for women. Delhi had one shelter which was closed down. Again, there was another shelter which has been opened because of the Supreme Court judgment, High Court
right.
judgment. And so as a result of it, most women are forced to sleep in the open with no shelter.
Right, and Indu Prakash Singh, I just want to ask you before we hand it, go to George, who has adopted Sunita, who is also now joining us. I just want to ask you, you know, what about pensions? What about the pension scheme for the elderly? Should there be some sort of health pension? Should there be some kind of reform in the pension scheme? What can be done so that people, even while they're young, save for their old age?
I think, you know, with regard to pension, I just want to say one thing here, that
the WHO has recommended a social health insurance, the Rashtriya Swastha Bima Yojana, which at the moment, of course, only applies to BPL families. But is there a way that the social health insurance can apply to all, so that at least at the, as far as health is concerned, you have a certain amount of funds at your disposal if you save through your life?
In fact, there is a dearth of such schemes, such pension policies, and I think that's lacking at a personal front, I think, for many people to save. Secondly, I think even at the government level, I think, you know, any pension schemes and all is a rarity. In fact, for the homeless people, there is not one scheme that reaches them, forget pension. And that's where groups like Pension Parishad and all, that's the movement has been set up
right.
by Arunaroy and Baba Adav and all, and we are part of it. I think we are asking for pensions for the homeless people, for the destitute people.
You're asking for universal pensions, yes, for the homeless elderly. Let me bring in the George Mesquita, who has in fact adopted Sunita Naik. George is over there. George, how did you decide to adopt Sunita, and what kind of help are you giving Sunita at the moment? George, if I could ask you, how did you decide to adopt Sunita, and what kind of help are you giving her at this moment? George, can you answer that?
I can't hear, couldn't hear.
No, Mr. George Mesquita, can you answer that?
Not George, it's Gregory Mesquita.
Gregory, sorry, I beg your pardon, your name was given to me as George.
Hello.
Yeah, Mr. Gregory, tell me, how did you decide to adopt Sunita Naik?
Like it just happened, I had the paper in my hand and I read her story and I said, that's it. I'll adopt her. I'm jobless myself.
Right.
So, I was a human being. I said, okay, I'll do something good. That's it.
So, are you keeping her with you in your house, and do you intend to keep her as long as she wants to stay?
Yes. Yes, of course.
And you say you're jobless yourself, so are you confident you'll be able to take care of her?
Of course. God is there. That's it.
Right. And is your family also cooperating in this? Is your family also happy to have Sunita there?
Well, I don't have a bloody family. Okay, my own family tried to kick me out of my own house, so I know what it feels to be kicked out.
Right, and are you going to make any attempt? Are you going to make any attempt to get in touch with her family or try and reach out to any of her friends or her family?
Well, she, according to Sunita, mummy. I call her mummy now. Okay, she doesn't have any family, nothing. And my only plan is, I want to get that, can I say, bitch who ruined her life, who took all her money from the banks. That is my plan. First thing, I want the police and all the politicians. They have been reading the news, but is any politician come and seen Sunita Naik today? I am fucking upset. Okay. Is any politician come forward to look at this woman, 65 years old?
Right. Gregory, thanks so much indeed for joining us. You're telling us that you're determined to make this into a police case. You're going to contact the police and try and track down the person who duped Sunita of her money. That's all we have time for on this particular edition of Face the People. Thanks very much indeed to all my panelists for in fact joining me. The question we have been asking is there no help available for those who suddenly fall on bad times, like Sunita Naik, particularly the elderly? Is there no help available either from the state or from the civic bodies that in fact operate in their name? What are you telling us? 56 are saying yes. Thanks so much for watching this edition of Face the People. We're back tomorrow with another People's Issue. Keep watching.